Larry Rothschild and the Yankees have divorced.
No.
It's kind of being portrayed as being fired, although the Yankees sent out glowing statements from Cashman and Boone about how great Larry is, and he's gone. So from what I heard, Larry was very into the analytics, but would push back every now and then. You've got to give Larry a lot of credit. Everybody's going to blame Larry for Sonny Gray. I don't blame Larry for Sonny Gray. I think that was Larry and the analytics. They wanted Sonny Gray to throw more breaking balls. He wasn't comfortable doing it. He goes to the Reds. They allow him to be the pitcher that he wanted. And I think that New York was too big for him. So does Larry get credit for turning Paxton into one of the best pitchers in baseball over the final 2 months? Does Larry get credit for straightening out Masahiro Tanaka, giving him a different grip on the splitter because of the different baseballs? I don't, again, I'm on the air right now. It's hard for me to find out exactly what happened. But the bottom line is there's some kind of fissure there. I don't know who is going to be the pitching coach of the Yankees. Would they revisit a guy like Dave Island, who they won a World Series with in 2009 and was let go by the Mets? Would they even think about David Cone, or is it going to be a real analytics-driven guy? My bet would be on a real analytics-driven guy, guy that you might not have ever heard of, who is lockstep with everything that they believe in. We'll see. But that certainly was surprising today when it happened.
Or is it just the fact that they want to make a little bit of a change, because they're probably not going to make a lot of changes during the offseason, and a lot of people within the organization felt this was a failure. At the very least, it was a disappointment.
Now, I don't think you could do that with people's lives, though, Don.
But that's what happens all the time, Michael.
But this guy's been there 9 years. It's not like he's not some insignificant figure. Well, let's use him as chum to the masses.
I don't think
Yankee Universe is upset with Larry Rothschild.
I don't know, but you did something. Sometimes you do things cosmetically.
That's a weak something, though.
I mean, sometimes you do things cosmetically. Maybe he was more of a Girardi guy. Maybe it's for the same reason. Like, maybe he was heavy-handed with the pitchers. They want maybe a lighter touch. Maybe they were okay to bring him back, and maybe Rothschild said, listen, I'd like to go with Girardi to Philadelphia. Maybe we can plan an exit strategy here. I don't know.
I'll try to find out. I'm not sure exactly what happened, but maybe I'll find out during the show. Maybe I'll find out after the show, but it does seem a little bit odd.
Is it possible that he wants to go to Philly to be with Girardi? Is that possible?
He's been
with the team since 2011, so obviously he was one of the assistants to Joe Girardi, so is it a change there? Is it just the fact that, hey, the Yankees aren't going to make a lot of changes? Because they won 100 games,
103.
Right? 103, won their division. But you got to throw somebody, I guess, under the bus when you have what is many people considered a failure of a season or a disappointment in the season. So is there that collateral damage? Hey,
don't know.
You know what? Our pitching wasn't as good as Houston's. We're probably not going to make a lot of changes. But this might actually signal that they're not going to go out and get Strasburg and Cole, that they're going to come back with the same guys. But we got to do something, because if we didn't hit our goal, somebody's got to be sacrificed. Is it that, or is it just, hey, Larry wants to go to Philadelphia and be with Joe Girardi?